Did you see Us yet?
I did not. Have you saw it?
Yeah, I saw it.
You liked it? Dude, you're just not intellectually woke enough to understand all of the complex concepts.
Yo! Welcome to BEERZ BARZ,
your place for rapid fire hip hop discussion and, of course, great beer.
I am Kamal Kiddo.
I am OT the Golden Child. Thank y'all for checking out last wheel, whenever it dropped, the last episode.
Yeah.
At Rev Brewing. Shout out to John and the whole staff over there for showing us all that was
major
the last episode,
love.
Right?
Major love. That was the last episode.
Showing us all the love that they showed us on that episode. It was a great. As you can see today, we still have, you know, leftovers because we are drinking.
Yeah.
Rev Brewing.
You know what? What are we drinking?
We are drinking their Northwest Hero IPA. I think I had this at the brewery, so I can't really speak to it much.
We got different beers, man.
From our packs that they sent us away.
Definitely. Man, shout out to Rev Brewing.
I don't think this was their hazy one, but I don't think. No, this is. I can tell by the body of it. It doesn't have a hazy look to it. Hazy joints, you can tell because it looks foggy and whatnot within the.
Yeah. True.
You're on it.
Look at my pour, man.
Oh, yeah. This is one of my more favorite ones from the night, man. Flavorful. Flavor. Flavor is just kicking. Not too hoppy, not too bitter. Juicy, tropical flavors and whatnot coming through on that joint. Very tasty beer.
Northwest Hero.
Yeah, this is one of the ones that he gave us out of the bale as we entered the little brew tour. And I was like, yo, I need some of these to go. And he was like, I got you. But yeah, man, good beer, man. 7.1% alcohol volume. So, yeah. You digging it?
I can feel it.
These are my favorite kinds, man. Here, these kinds that you can.
It's hoppy. This guy.
Yeah, but I definitely can. You know, I can taste like the tropical flavors and whatnot in it. You know what I'm saying? I like my IPAs a little bit. Like I said, my favorite IPA is the Dogfish Head Romantic Chemistry, because it's just popping with flavor, dude. What's this episode about?
Yo, us. I'll check for that Dogfish, but
not us, but us.
True.
Hey.
Not the movie, but these two guys.
Yeah, man.
That you see every week, every other week.
Yeah.
If you didn't know, the both of us are artists.
We are creators, man.
We are creators.
That's right.
And we both have projects currently in the stratosphere.
Yeah, those and whatnot, yeah.
What you got popping, man?
I have an album that just dropped recently called Pop's Playlist. 11 tracks, or really 9 tracks. Two of them are, you know, like conversational pieces and whatnot between me and my father. So, but I'm counting as 11 because that's how I come up on all streaming platforms. So
true. Come up on all streaming platforms. Hey, nice.
What do you have going on?
I have Untitled Playlist. Okay. It is a film, as well as a soundtrack.
Okay.
But to be fair, it kind of started as a soundtrack.
Yeah.
Or as a mixtape.
Okay.
Of beats. And I put like visuals to every beat.
Okay.
Into a DVD,
there you go.
Into a DVD.
Yes, and on your shirt there, you can see the...
Oh, yeah, and on my shirt, you know.
Now, when the people come and want to see, when they listen to it, they want to listen to it on streaming platforms, it's going to have a different...
Oh, yes. So,
yes.
Good news. Word to Pop's Playlist, there's a song on there called Follow the Omens, and tonight, we were going to record Monday, but we're recording... tonight, and I can say that when this episode drops, Untitled Playlist will be on all streaming platforms.
That's right.
To be able to listen to. Before, it was only on SoundCloud. Right now, before, it was only on SoundCloud. Now, it's on all your streaming platforms, Apple Music, Tidal, Spotify, all of that.
Yeah.
But it is called Lamborghini Beats.
We'll get into why.
Yeah. Okay, we'll get
into why. If we kind of want to get to this.
Okay, we'll get
into why. So how do we want to have, do you want to just have general conversation about the project? So are we asking questions? What are we doing?
Well, I mean, I can...
We're interviewing each other.
Right, we're interviewing each other today. And I think I want to ask you some questions, man. I think I want to, like, I've been listening to this album a lot.
Yeah.
Pop's Playlist, man.
Yes.
I've been waiting on this album for a long time.
Me too.
So, first of all, just, I'm a fan of good packaging. I'm a fan of you know, and I don't want to sound like I'm gassing you just because I'm your man. Right. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But I think that it is a good piece of work. You know what I'm saying?
Appreciate it.
Shout out to Danny.
DJ Sparks.
Who did the cover.
Yeah.
It's colorful. It's popping. And I like... I know the what's behind this, but let's start with that.
Mm-hmm.
What's the significance of this cover?
Significance of the cover, if you pay attention to the covers, is actually pieces of each of the instrumentals from the original artist. So everything is kind of pieced together weirdly, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So Mercy Me is from a song from Cannonball Adderley. The actual cover for that album is on there. Nobody Knows is from Pastor T, LT Barrett, I believe, I'm not sure.
Yeah.
Lonnie Liston, that's the Be Present joint. All of the original artwork from those artists make up this artwork.
Wow.
It's a collage of the original albums. So, yeah.
Fire. That's fire. I really, really like this cover. You know what I'm saying? When you get merch and you put it on a hoodie.
Which will happen.
Let me know.
Mm-hmm.
I already got the art direction for that, actually.
Oh, snap. I mean,
this cover is pretty fire.
Yeah.
But all right. So just looking at that alone, I like the cover going into it, and then your pops comes in. You know what I'm saying? You're talking to your pops.
Yeah.
Okay, that's dope. You know what I'm saying? But then YMD comes in. Why did you choose YMD to start the album?
Because if you listen, you know what I'm saying, my pops is kind of talking about dream. Well, he's kind of talking or alluding to what he never thought would happen. You know, he's talking about him when he was a kid or him when he was a young man. And he was doing his own thing with music and he never thought that, you know, he would see me doing what I'm doing, and he glad that I took it to a different place. And then that's why that song comes in the way it does, because it's very just, it's only right.
It's a good opener track.
Exactly.
It's a perfect opener track.
Yeah. And they are young man dreams, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Talking about, it's like you line up these things that you want, but you also...
Let's play that. Can we play that?
Yeah, let's do it. It's like you talking about all these things that you know, all you want to do is ball out, so on and so forth, but you trying to be honorable at the same time, because you still got to make your moms proud. You still got to make your pops proud. But yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Right.
So, you got YMD, which stands for
Young Man Dreams.
Young Man Dreams.
Yeah.
And then we move into Silk Thoughts.
Just popping. Just swagging.
I agree.
There's nothing more to that one besides just Bob James. great jazz funk. Do, 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 do. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, yeah, heavily sampled as well. Bob James, a lot of his music was sampled in hip hop. So,
let's take it back one hot second. So why is it called Pop's Playlist?
Pop's Playlist literally because it was about a year and a half ago. I would say I was tired of rap because of our show. We consume a lot of music.
True.
And I'm like, yo, I gotta give this a break.
True.
So naturally, I went to the person that I know had a lot of music, which was Pop's.
True.
And I told him, yo, can you send me some instrumentals? Mm-hmm. Send me some of your music that you listen to, jazz, funk, whatever. Mm-hmm. And that's how it started. He started just sending me. I didn't even know he could text. You know what I'm saying? He just texted me. And we amassed maybe like a 70-song playlist. And then I started rapping over a lot of those instrumentals. And then I was like, yo, I got in a real creative space where like, yo, I should really make a project where I'm really just flowing over these joints. And I was having a lot of ideas come up in general, like a lot of thoughts. As a 30-something-year-old man transitioning in life.
Yeah.
And you hear a lot of that on here. You hear a lot of who I am presently and my ideas and thoughts.
That's another thing I want to get to. As we move through some of these songs, we got conversations in the kitchen. Mm-hmm. It's obviously with your pops. Mm-hmm. YMD, Young Man Dreams. Silk Thoughts is probably the only song that's titled that's like straight playful.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Everything else is pretty serious.
Yeah, everything else is really straightforward, thought provoking
content. Yeah. But you got Young Man Dreams, you got Be Present, and after Be Present, you have Effects of Nostalgia.
Yeah.
Which talks about what?
Effects of Nostalgia.
It's my favorite. Let's play that.
Okay.
It's my favorite, but here's the thing. Let me get to that real quick. First of all, Be Present, all right?
Yeah.
Be Present is about being present, being in the moment, being, you know what I'm saying, present.
Yeah.
I take it to mean being detached from your phone, because in the sense, you know, and that means a lot.
Yeah.
In this day and age.
Yeah.
The phone has a lot of stuff in it.
Yeah.
It can do a lot. It's connected to our world. Mm-hmm. It's not just a phone. Mm-hmm. It does a lot. But if we detach from it and be present with the people around us and make moves and, what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's important for people to hear.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? But then there's Effects of Nostalgia. And what's interesting about the song, to me, is that it opens with your pops, right?
Yeah.
Talking about
living in the past, thinking about the past, to a point where I had to let go if I wanted to move on to the future.
And that's an important thing to know, to pass on to someone, right?
Yeah.
And then that's kind of repeated again with the singer at the end. What's his name?
David Be Loved. Yeah.
He did his thing.
Yeah.
Don't go back. Gotta move on. Don't go back. Mm-hmm. Right. I get that. Mm-hmm. The middle part is the fun part, the rapping part.
Yeah.
And it's all about, it's interesting because it's all about the past, right? And it's drawing you into those memories. Mm-hmm. But you saying don't go back.
Yeah. That's intentional.
Why?
Because I think a lot of times...
I make sense just now?
Yeah. You did, yeah. Because what I'm doing is I'm really romanticizing about how good the past is. Like, my whole verse, I'm talking about the good old days.
Yes.
But the point of the song is that a lot of people get stuck in the good old days. And they just always think about... They don't recognize, or they think that things used to be good. You know, and that things don't have the opportunity now to be better. You know what I mean? That's kind of how Be Present and Effects of Nostalgia kind of play in together. Because I'm reminiscing about, the summertime and blah, 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 blah. You know, people have whole conversations about, man, remember when we used to go kick it and party, blah, blah, blah. Well, you don't really do that no more now. And every time you get up with your homies, that's all you talk about. You know? Like, are y'all talking about things now that y'all can do and help each other out and maybe go forward in something else? Or do y'all just reminisce and romanticize about the past? That's why David comes in. I keep thinking about the past. He transitions. It's a transition. Because I'm romanticizing, and he comes like, yeah.
Interesting, dude.
Yeah.
Let's hear a little bit of that. Let's hear a little bit of that. That's my favorite joint.
This is a lot of people's favorite right now, man.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But it's like, it's so good, but the singing at the end is so... It's dang, dude. It's kind of like a snapback into reality.
It is.
You know what I'm saying? All of this, everything you're saying, so positive. Oh, yeah, I remember. Dang, that's crazy. Okay. Autobiographical rap. I like autobiographical rap.
Yeah.
And then you say, nah, I'm going to get all that.
It's not really a forget because the past can be, it's supposed to be a teacher, but it's not a place to sit in. Not a place to sit in, and I wrote that part. So I wrote the whole. Originally, it was me singing. My singing wasn't as good as David's. We gotta shoot a video to this.
Bruh. You need to have a barbecue, G.
Okay.
You need to have a barbecue.
And then you just come shoot the footage.
Yes.
That can work. That can work.
You need to have a barbecue, G.
Yeah.
I have it in my mind.
We can do it.
Your pops need to be grilling.
Okay.
I need to.
That's very.
To get footage.
We can actually. That's nothing. That's nothing. Okay. Yeah.
There you have it. Coming soon.
Yeah. That we just really spaced out right there.
So. So. All right. That's my favorite joint.
Okay.
You got Identity Crisis. So you got Be Present. Into.
Really get serious.
It's being into the effects of nostalgia, thinking about the past. Mm-hmm. Then you talk about Identity Crisis.
Yeah.
What do you mean by Identity Crisis?
What I mean is that we've talked on the show before about how political the times are. What I'm really talking about is people who, how you can't think a certain way because of your group. You belong to a certain group or tribe, okay. And you have to a lot of times think a certain way. Otherwise, you know, you're ousted, or it's like, yo, you are this, you're black, or you're Christian, mm-hmm. you're Muslim, you're mm-hmm. gay, you're transsexual, whatever. Mm-hmm. Or you can, what's even crazy, you can be a part of all, which is a real conundrum. Like, what if you are all of those? Like, you know what I mean? But anyway, I'm basically talking about how you can't think differently, you know, and how you have to see people for who they are. You know, what do you respect about me? You look at me and then you doubt me. You think you know me so much, your attention, your based on falsehoods, that's no love. In fact, that's just hate. We're living in a mean world where the facts have come to us fake. Got me thinking about our fate and my kids growing up in a place that's filled with hella hate. We don't know a lot, but act like we got the knowledge because I wasn't learning about the books back in college. I was studying people, just to be honest, once you hear somebody's story. And what I'm talking about is, in order to know who somebody really is, who's a other, you have to know them.
Mm-hmm.
I can't hate you or think about a certain way about you because it looks like you belong to a different identity group. And I can just say you white, so you probably racist.
Identity crisis. Okay,
you
I got
what I'm
you.
Like,
I got you. I got you.
Or because you think differently because of, you know, like we was on the show and we was like, we didn't think that Gucci was being intentionally racist, right? Mm-hmm. That's not a black opinion. You see what I'm saying? Like, if people were to see that, see us young black men saying that, it's like, what's up with them dudes? What? You see what I'm saying?
Right.
Because we've stepped out of our identity with that opinion, because that's not.
But have we though?
I would say, and
here's what I have not, because that's what I believe.
Yes, but you. But what I'm saying though is that you're young and black, right?
Yeah.
That's not a typical young black opinion regarding Gucci. Everybody else is going in. Nah, G A blah blah blah. Most people, you see what I'm saying?
Group think.
Exactly. The song is really about group think. Yeah. Yeah, it's really poignant, especially in these times we live in. You can't have a multivariate or nuanced way of thinking. Because things are complicated, you should have a nuanced way of thinking.
True.
But you can't. What if your opinion is different from...
You can.
You can, but there's a cost for it.
It's a cost.
Socially, yeah.
Wow.
And then, I think what ties it up is the singing at the end. It's like, yo, you know what? Why can't we just fucking get along here, people? Like, that's why I kept it. I think his verse is more important than mine, to be honest with you.
Yeah. Tell me why. Now you're talking real podcast. Yeah. You're talking real podcasty right now. Okay.
And that's a real like existential crisis that I kind of have at this point, meaning that like I really fear what's to come for just the time. Like I'm really afraid of the 2020 election and what and how crazy it's going to be. You know what I'm saying? Like, these are the thoughts that make songs like these.
True.
Like, my thinking ass. You know what I'm saying?
Right, get your big. Right,
yeah, but, true. Yeah.
Wow, this is heavy really content. Is.
Yeah, it really is.
Then you got more conversations in the kitchen with Pops.
Too long, right? You said it was too long. I should have cut it off.
I thought it was a little long.
I was long with it, yeah. But it comes on the back of a racial conversation, so.
Right, it's over 2 minutes.
My question was 80 minutes long, but yeah.
I need 80 seconds.
Yeah.
But then Mercy Me, I really could have dealt with a third verse. I really liked the joint.
It's a short satire.
You know what I'm saying? I could have dealt with a third verse.
Yeah, I feel you.
You know what I'm saying? I thought that the storytelling was good, mm-hmm. and it got a point across well. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. The guy who, what's the one line? He trying to wrap his mind around how he can.
My brother. So it's kind of plays out like a linear story, but it's not. But in that respect, it does. It's like my brother's straight. He got problems that he can't escape. The church kicked him out because they couldn't pray the gay away. He trying to wrap his mind around how Jesus saves just the place you're supposed to meet him at, say you couldn't stay. Mm. So there's a...
Slow it down. Say that last part one more time. Slow it down.
My brother's straight. He got problems that he can't escape. The church kicked him out because they couldn't pray the gay away.
Right.
He trying to wrap his mind around how Jesus saves if the place you're supposed to meet him at, say you couldn't stay.
Mm.
So there's a, you know...
Preach!
It's very satirical. It's like, oh, but it's like, wait a minute. It's really a...
True.
You know?
True.
Same way with the KKK. They never met me, but they know a nigga black. They probably never met a nigga, but they know how niggas act. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Or do they?
These are just satirical, like... Right.
Situations that I'm kind of throwing out to give you to chew on. You know?
True. Right. Yeah, man. Mercy Me, I could have definitely dealt with a third verse. Yeah. Nobody Knows is probably the one of the best tracks as far as just straight raw rap to me.
It's the single.
You know what I'm saying?
It's the single.
The beat is perfect for that. This beat alone made me think about Jay-Z's 444, dude. And so right after this, on the way here, I've been listening to the album a lot anyway. But right after this, I put on 444, because
it's a very grown album, and
it's like, well, I don't even know what to Yeah, 444 is pretty heavy, but that's another whole. Mm-hmm. But with this album, though, like, this is very heavy. You know what I'm saying? Sure,
it really is.
It's jamming, but it's very heavy.
It really is, yeah.
And not in a Lupe Fiasco.
I was gonna say, it's not a Lupe. That's
like,
heavy.
It's not like intricate heavy.
You can understand what the concepts that I'm throwing at you.
It's well fed. Mm-hmm. And it's not, but it's not basic. It's like, you know what I'm saying? It's so nobody knows. Mm-hmm. Chris Shields, shout out to Chris Shields, who's been on the show before.
My man's, what's going on? Yeah.
I was really concerned about his top five of the year, that year. But bro can rap, and he got some lines in there, G. Like, when a line hits you, when a bar hits you, like, ooh, he went crazy. So, and you realize, like, when you first hear a song, and you might be listening intently, and you catch a bar, and you might not catch something, and you might be like, and then, like, listens later, you catch something.
Yeah.
I had that feeling listening to his verse.
Me and Shields, first of all, I produced on his first album, you know. Shields is like a hometown hero from Maywood and whatnot, you know what I'm saying? I was producing in college, you know, you know what I'm saying? We started producing together.
True.
I was on his first album, and many times we had talked about working together, but I read his book called God's Work, Not Mine. And it was like the stars was aligning. I'm like, okay, I read his story, you know what I'm saying? The whole book is dope, you know what I'm saying? It's kind of centered around, you know, his fiance and whatnot as well, you know? And I'm like, I got to get him on Nobody Knows, because I know he can speak to, you know, pain and holding, you know what I'm saying, on to things and smiling through struggle and all that.
Mm-hmm.
His verse is necessary, because my verses are introspective, personal, and his is as well, but his verse gives you that rap. Mm-hmm. Like, he punching. I'm going introspective, you know what I'm saying? And personal story. His verse kind of...
What's the one line that I was pointing out earlier?
I seen it all. I'm just kicking facts. Another day, another dollar, 50 cents. No, what did he say? I seen sons who
got daddies who ain't into them praising. Who ain't into them praising.
Yeah, something like that. So they growing up fast, man. They internet agent. Ending in cages. Then he goes, I seen it all. I'm just kicking facts. Another day, another dollar. 50 cent to make you get the strap. No chasing when I'm sipping yak. This everyday struggle is complex. Like, you need that.
This is everyday struggle is complex.
I'm not rapping like that. He coming with like, them punches. You see what I'm saying? It was necessary, man. Like,
oh my
that
God.
Verse is crazy.
Oh my God.
You know
what I'm saying?
Like, yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
And then you hate the album from here on out.
Well, see, here's the thing. So
the album's so gonna end here.
The last joint, Follow the Omens, like the official last joint, Follow the Omens.
Yes.
Is lyrically, message wise, really good.
That's the only reason why it's on here. Yeah.
It's really good.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You see the keys if you freeze the frame. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? It's jewels in there. These are jewels. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. These are jewels. The beat, though.
Yeah.
The way you rapping on it.
I'm literally.
It felt.
Yeah.
No. Cumbersome. Clumsy,
which is why I didn't want to put it on here. I didn't really. It almost didn't make it, but I feel like it's so, the messaging so ties up everything so much.
Yeah.
I'm literally rapping over a band that's off timing. Yeah. They're speeding up, they're slowing down. The second and third verse. The first verse is like one part of the loop. That's easy. Second and third verse is a part of the beat in which they just going crazy. Yeah. They speeding up, they slowing down, and I'm trying to catch it as I'm rapping.
Yeah.
I'm literally rapping over a live band that's doing whatever the hell they want to do. But
true,
it's art, and I kept it on there because of the messaging. And
I feel
honestly,
I feel you.
Sparks, I don't know. I don't know why, but Sparks loves this joint.
Into the mind of an artist.
Yeah.
Like, I get why he likes it. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like,
Candace love it. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, for me, it's not the best vocal performance on this.
I skip it.
But I think that the message is really good.
I shouldn't say that. I didn't say that.
Yeah,
love this song. It's the best song on the album.
Hey, look. And then song for
that's a bonus
song for Sons.
I just felt like it was necessary. A bonus joint. Shout out to AJ that produced that.
True. Jordan also does our intro, outro.
Yes. Jordan loves the song. Jordan really, you know, my second son, you know. It's just I'm talking to my sons about their story. You know, this is it's really personal, you know.
True.
I really felt like I was too hard on my first son. You know, you know what I'm saying? Like I really the story about Jordan and my wife and his second name coming from her uncle, you know what I'm saying, being gunned down in 2010. Like, it's a real...
Yeah, I remember that.
You know what I mean? So, yeah, man. Yeah.
Wow, Jay.
Check that joint out, though. Pop's Playlist,
man. Pop's Playlist, man. It's on Apple Music, Tidal, everywhere. Spotify, everywhere. That you can get music.
Yes.
Yo, I want to check if I could get that on Alexa. Hey, Alexa. Play Pop's Playlist.
Norm do it. Yeah, Norm said it's on
it. Wow, that's fire, G.
Yeah, it's doing well too, man. I appreciate everybody. People are really.
It's a good project.
All I wanted was for people to hear my thoughts and my ideas, man. And people are really rocking with it.
Yeah.
And the streaming is saying that. And I'll be checking my stats and stuff. So appreciate y'all.
True. Video's coming soon.
That's the next evolution of that.
True that.
Switching it up. Are you ready?
Susu Switch and Selector!
Alright. Untitled Playlist.
Oh, dang.
Yeah, you get you a beer, sir.
I know, right? Let me go ahead and get a beer.
Untitled Playlist. DVD.
Yeah, man.
Instrumental. Both of them together, right? Well.
Yes.
Not together, but you get the DVD. And then you can, at this point, you can stream the...
Yes. So, caveat real quick. Yeah. It is Kamal Kiddo Presents Untitled Playlist.
Yes.
On all streaming platforms, it is going to come out as Lamborghini Beats, though.
Yes.
If I can figure out through the distributor how to put the caption on there, the description, I'm going to be saying that it is called Untitled Playlist.
Yes.
But, the distributor would not take
the independent grind and hustle, man.
The distributor would not take Untitled as part of my title for my album.
Get your real stupid goop yet.
No, I know, right? Fam. You know what I'm saying?
Goop ass. But look, like, okay.
Dang, G. So it's called Lamborghini Beats because there's a...
On all streaming platforms.
Right? On all streaming platforms, yes.
What is the
what
is the inception of the project here? What started, because Pop's Playlist came from a place of, you know, me and my pops connecting, blah, 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 good job there, right? What is the inception here for you? What is the idea that kicked this off?
Okay, interesting. So, you know how iTunes, you know, when you first bring up a playlist, like, or you're about to make a playlist, it says Untitled Playlist.
Yes.
Or it'll just say Untitled Playlist. So I didn't really like, I was thinking about using that as a cover.
Yeah.
Like the iTunes image of the music note as a cover. Mm. You know what I'm saying? But that's a little too iconic, like too recognizable, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But I thought that, man, I'm not really trying to be a producer, but I like making beats. Yeah. I'm not trying to get on as a producer, but I really like doing film.
Right.
But I can't produce.
Yeah.
So, you know what? I'm going to do a project where I can make beats, but also I want to be able to do a project where I don't have to rely on anybody else and make a film, you know what I'm saying? And make a project, just make a visual project.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And so that's how I kind of started.
Okay.
And it's probably been in my mind since like maybe 2014. Mm-hmm. It's been sitting on my computer in pieces. Mm-hmm. But then in like 2017, I'm like, man, I need to do something with this joint.
Mm-hmm. So that's been in fruition for 3 years then.
Yeah, G.
Okay.
And I started to like, you know what? That'd be dope if this was like this and this was like this and this was like that. Let me holler at my guy. Cause I ain't really trying to make no more beats. Like, part of that producing is fun, but I don't like sequencing the beat. You know what I'm saying? It's like it takes the, cause I produce on Fruity Loops.
Right.
So sequencing it is the annoying part. Mm. If I learned on an NPC, which is much more of a live feel,
you just playing it out.
I could just play it out, and that's like, ooh, I like if I got an idea, I could just start to bang it out.
Yeah.
If NPC is easy to use, someone send me a tutorial on YouTube or something, you know what I'm saying? But so since I didn't like really producing, I hollered at my guy Malari.
Right.
Ugly Boy Modeling on all streaming platforms.
Yeah.
But I'm like, man, G, you got beats, and I know you can produce. I got a gang of samples, G. Yo, make me like just make some joints, and let me just pick some joints.
So he did a good amount of the actual.
He did like it's like 3 or 4 beats on there.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying, from Malari, G.
Okay.
From Ugly Boy Modeling.
That's what's up.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
So. One of my main questions that I wanted to ask is, what is the, how do you pick the visual? Because this project, right, it's 11 tracks, right? Well, as far as the actual DVD, it's 11 joints and it's 11 instrumentals, right?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
What is the marriage, or how do you pick the visual to match? What is the thought process of picking the visual to match the instrumental? Is that just abstract, or is it actually some type of centered thought process with that?
Well, I think any director would, any like real serious director, auteur director, who really cares about the platform of film, thinks about the music that's going to go under the visual.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? With this, I did it the reverse way, you know what I'm saying? I made the music first and thought, and was just listening to it, and what I thought it might sound like, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So I picked all the beats that I thought were good and strung them together.
Right.
With the samples and all of that, you know what I'm saying? With no visions in mind at all.
Right.
The beats came first.
Mm-hmm.
Strung that together with the vocal samples and all that.
Mm-hmm.
And then I put the visuals on top of it.
Okay.
And just listened to it and was like, man, this kind of sound like Saturday morning. Cartoon, this sound like cartoons.
Right.
This sound like cartoons.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Crying Mother, man, this sound like some soap opera type stuff.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
You're giving the details up.
Okay. So I'm like, right, man, this sound like a, Diane, how could you?
Right, exactly. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I feel you.
So I'm like, so I started stringing those ideas together.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So each beat has a theme.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
In that sense.
Okay.
Yeah.
Question with that. So the movie Us is out right now, right? Right. And everybody has all these hidden meanings and messagings and whatnot, right?
True.
That people are like,
true.
Is that, if you can speak to this, I don't know if you can or not. When you come up with the visuals, is at any point there any messaging that goes behind any of the, like, is
so,
now you found the visual for that actually tied into something about finding something? Is the visual to dreams about, like, is there any messaging with any?
I'm gonna have to say no.
Okay.
I'm gonna have to say no. I think that there are some messages. There are some messages in there, but they're plainly written in.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I don't mean like there's a metaphor message.
Mm.
I mean it's a direct words on the screen. you know what I'm saying? With Now You Found, some of these titles come from different places. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like Now You Found is titled Now You Found because
the sample, maybe, or
the sample is Now You Found.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But the visual is really just the intro to the album.
Mm.
The visual is really just the intro to the DVD.
Mm.
The intro to the film.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So the whole thing is the intro.
Right.
I rock with Lamborghinis.
Yeah, I was gonna ask about that. I'll save it.
So the intro is all Lamborghinis.
Right.
Except for the Tatra, which is the V8, which is from I pulled a visual from Kanye's Runaway,
mm-hmm.
and it's not a Lamborghini,
mm-hmm.
it's a Tatra, but it's still a dope car.
Mm-hmm.
But I say that also, it's on the screen.
Right.
It yeah. says words of Kanye.
Right.
I rock with the Tatra too.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's on the screen.
Mm-hmm.
So there are fun hidden things like that that right. you know what I'm saying? It's designed to for you it's a loop.
Right.
If you played it and just let it play, it will loop on its own. Mm-hmm. It's a loop.
Right.
The whole thing is a loop.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And the DVD is a loop.
Right.
Like, the album itself is not a loop.
Right.
But the DVD is a loop.
Mm-hmm.
It starts with the car, mm-hmm. and it ends with the car. That was intentional.
Right.
It's a loop. It's designed, and there are instructions on here
right.
for you to play it yeah, as a loop. It's like right. a visual, it's like a, you know, it can play at a bar,
right.
it can play at a gallery,
right.
you know what I'm saying? With the music down, on mute,
right.
and you can be enjoying a party.
Right.
But if you so choose, you can watch it when you get to the crib, and it's an entertaining movie, I think.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Think so as
you'll
well.
Be entertained yeah. by it.
Very abstract.
And it's just visuals.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's just visuals.
Mm.
But I think you can still watch it.
Right.
Without the music.
Right. One of my favorite instrumentals that stood out to me.
Mm-hmm. So I produced this one.
Okay.
This is Bracelets.
Yeah.
This is Bracelets. The sample. I forget what the sample is called, but it had something to do with bracelets stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I don't remember. It might have been called something necklace. I don't remember.
Right.
Come to find out, when we did Capital Punishment, mm-hmm. Big Pun.
Yes.
I think we might have talked about it on one of the classic years.
Mm-hmm. We did.
They said he uses like one of the beats. Is mm-hmm. this, and I ain't even realized that.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? Like, for years, I ain't listened to Big Pun, Capital Punishment in years.
Mm-hmm.
And when I heard it, I'm like, wow.
The sample is on there.
That same sample is on there, G.
Yes.
But yeah, so, the visual.
Yeah.
All right, so, it's all rare footage of, you know what I'm saying, actual footage of me shooting different things.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like real life, everything in life,
mm-hmm.
different life stuff.
Right.
When I got the camera and I'm recording something,
mm-hmm.
that's what I put in there.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So that's really all that is.
Okay.
That's really all it is. You
know what I'm saying? The Love Suite.
Oh yeah.
That is dedicated to the grown and sexy.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to say that.
I'm gonna have to say that.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to say that.
there is some imagery there that's, you know, a little provocative and whatnot.
Very much so.
Yeah. That's one of my favorite parts, though.
Yeah. Okay.
Is that one of the joints, or one of the joints from there is with Ugly and L, right? Is that?
Oh, yeah.
Which one is that? That's in that.
That's Intimacy.
I think that's my favorite visual from the project, probably.
Yeah, so I've had that visual for a long time. Like, I think the best videos are like a basic idea.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, not too real, like, you know, sometimes really intricate storyline.
Yeah.
Visuals are, if not done well, can be extra. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And forgettable.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Just another video.
Yes.
But I thought I had that, like, the concept originally came from Darren Aronofsky's Black Swan. The movie Black Swan.
Yeah.
With Natalie Portman.
Yes.
And
yes.
Mila Kunis.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of it is just following her from behind.
Yeah.
A lot of the movie is just following Natalie Portman from behind her.
Yes.
That's dope.
Mm-hmm.
So I tried my hand at it.
Right. What the hell, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I tried my hand at it.
Yeah.
Shout out to Darren Aronofsky.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I want to talk about the last track on here real quick. This is probably my favorite. The instrumental probably, and it's mainly the guy talking.
Oh.
Bruh. Not because I'm rapping on it.
Yes.
But I want to mention this. I really can hear your RZA influence here.
Oh, definitely. Without a doubt.
Yeah.
This is I wouldn't be surprised if RZA might have used this sample, but I don't know if he has or not.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But as soon as I heard it, I'm like, oh, okay. This is RZA. And I didn't do anything to it, but
the bells.
Boost the drums in it itself.
What about the bells?
You know what I'm saying? Now that I added.
Okay.
That I added. But this is none of me.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
I just boosted the sample itself on the bass side.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because it's perfect.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's a straight loop.
Yeah. Fire.
It's a straight loop. I tried to shout out to Mike, you know what I'm saying, my guy Mike. I tried to slide this to 2 Chainz in a roundabout way.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh my God, I can hear 2 Chainz on here. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, go crazy on it, G.
Yeah.
Yeah, go crazy on it.
Ah.
2 Chainz, here we kill it.
Yeah.
It's here.
Mm-hmm.
You gotta get on the track with Otito. Because OT is, I know I wanted music videos, original music videos on a project, on a DVD.
Yes.
So, I definitely recorded yours. Yours was the first video.
Okay.
To this joint.
Yeah.
And did I let you pick a beat or did I give you this beat?
I think I
wanted you to rap.
You gave me this and I was like, fuck yeah. Yeah, no problem. I was done writing within like an hour.
Yeah. So I didn't even have a title for this joint. The fact that you started rapping what you rapped, I put you rapped what you rapped, and then I think I put the audio vocals on after.
Yes, you did. Wow. Damn, you rhymed, I think.
Did I?
Well, no, the Oracle part was in there.
The Oracle part was in there, but I'm talking about on the DVD, there's audio.
You're right, the boy talking, right?
Yeah.
No, yes.
Of
only realized that, blah, blah, blah. Yes.
The universe is this and that.
Yeah.
The I that I think of is not me, but I then, whatever you say. Gee, I'm like, gee, okay. On top of your, like, metaphysical rapping, I'm like, I'm gonna call it Who Am I?
Exactly.
I didn't even have a title for it.
That's crazy.
I named it off of that.
That could have been on Pop's playlist, this joint. It sounds like it.
It sounds like it, G. Like, that's just the rapper you are, though, G.
You know, I
that's the writer you are.
I pulled from the boy. The boy was talking about, you know, those metaphysical things that at the beginning. So I was like, and I just wrote with that.
True. Yeah. There was nothing there, though, when I originally gave it to you.
Oh, wow.
The boy was there.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Yeah, I wrote from
if the spoon bends, exactly. That was there. Yeah, that was there.
Yeah.
Because he said the oracle in it.
Yeah.
But other than that,
Yeah. Untitled playlist,
man. It's a whole DVD.
If you're going to check it, you can buy these right now. It's only $10, right?
Yes.
It's $10, man.
It's an art piece. Look at that. It's an art piece.
What are you doing with your
Why
life?
Why is $10 and it's wait, hold on.
You're tipsy. It's okay.
I know,
it's
right?
Like the formula thoughts.
It's $10 and it's only 20 minutes.
Yeah.
It's only like 20 minutes, 21, 22 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
There's another bonus. There's a bonus film on here, Italy. There's a bonus film. I like bonus DVDs.
Yeah.
Who plays DVDs? Who still uses DVDs? I know. But it's an art piece.
Yeah, man. Look
at this, man. It's beautiful.
We're creators, man. I'm gonna tell you like this.
Oh, dang. I thought I was in here all this time. I'm showing up.
It's in my computer.
An empty box, man.
The more we continue throughout this year, you'll see that we really want to try to bring everybody into this whole thing. Is like just a conversation. We talk. This is hip hop. I rap. He does art and whatnot. We creators. We drink.
I did this cover.
Exactly.
Shout out to Jeremy Pettis though, who my guy, my graphic designing homie,
yeah.
who actually drafted up the cover itself.
Yeah.
But I shot the Lamborghini.
Wait, an actual Lamborghini?
It's my toy Lamborghini.
Okay.
It's a toy.
All right, I was going to say, you should have robbed that nigga.
But yeah, G.
Let me shoot your cop, fam. All right, cool.
I know, right?
All right. Beerz and Barz, we appreciate y'all. Next time we will...
Pop's playlist, Untitled playlist.
You got to check both of these things out in conjunction, man. You know what I'm saying?
Lamborghini beats.
Exactly. Yeah, Lamborghini beats on streaming platforms. True. We'll see y'all next time with 1999, the classics.
Ooh.
I'm done drinking. He's not.
Yikes.
Peace.
Peace.